Alrighty, so it's been a hot minute since we've used Assault Mode Meliodas, and with the new Red Tarmiel Grace, I used him a little bit in a video that I did last week whenever Tarmiel first came out, and he was actually pretty good. So I think in the last video I used Sigurd whenever I had him on the team, but we're going to try it with Cusack just in case we come up against any bonds, because I'm going to be playing Geared. So I guess we'll kind of see if... if it doesn't go as well, maybe we can swap back to Sigurd. I don't know for sure. I know the setup looks a little bit different today, and I know that the light in the background makes me look really dark, but I really can't do anything about that at the moment. I am currently cat sitting for a friend of mine, so I'm at his house while he's out of town. So the setup is a little wonky, kind of. I've tried to get it as decent as possible for the time being, at least until we get back to my house. So let's see what we can do here. So I think obviously the big threat is going to be King, so let's try to go ahead and get some damage out on him if possible. I almost wonder if I should have saved one of the cleave cards to try to get rid of the shield. Well, we got double cleave card there, so that's actually really good. Obviously the Deanne taunt could be quite a big issue as well, but we'll see how that goes. He literally disabled nothing because this team doesn't really deal with any buffs. He's already attacking me, which is kind of interesting. I really wasn't expecting him to actually go for the attacks, and he also did not he did not put up a taunt, so I guess that's good as well. Nice kill there. I feel like I'm using Cusack a little bit more than I should be, but that's fine. I really don't get to use Cusack a whole lot, and I actually really like Cusack as a character, so we'll at least be able to try out his ultimate here. Well, no, he has two different ways to get rid of my ultimate, so I kind of doubt I get it off. Never mind. This is either a bot or a very bad player. I'm pretty sure it's a bot. So, all right, he puts up the taunt. Let's go for something like this. I would hope that that would be enough to kill. Here we go. Bam. Nice damage. That's enough to kill, and then maybe we hit... Okay, well, I was kind of hoping for Gother, but that's fine. If I would have pulled any extra melee cards, I would have tried to go for his ult, because I feel like that's normally the best course of action, is to go for Melee's ult, because, you know, he builds up. But literally didn't pull anything on this, so kind of unfortunate. I do really like that Abyss effect on Cusack, though. Very cool. Let's go for just try to get some damage off, try to get him out of the way. I think we'll go ahead and move on to the next match, because there's not really much left for me to do in this one, besides beat through two supporty style characters. So be right back. Alrighty, we got another team. It is another King team. It's got pretty decently high CC. I can only imagine this is a real player using CC food. Honestly, it's actually funny to see people forfeit against a counter melee in 2022. Okay, we're gonna try the camera like this maybe, because the light isn't in the background. So, I don't know, weird camera angle, not a big fan, but oh well. We have an awful team here. I think we go for... I don't really need to worry about putting up the taunt just yet. That evasion food's actually really annoying. Alright. Okay. Blocking skill effects on him isn't really all that good. I just kind of wanted to remove some HP, but he has made that harder than it needs to be. Alright, so he's literally just rushing a melee ult. He doesn't have any sort of... whatchamacallit, he doesn't have any sort of ultimate removal or taunt or anything like that, so I'm going to kill him for one, but I can remove his ultimate with Cusack, which is really nice. It's really nice that Cusack even has that ultimate removal card. Dude, what is this team? The fact that he didn't out CC me with this team is actually ridiculous, because this team is just all festival units, and Vaughn is HP defense. Yeah, Escanor has a lot. I don't know what to think about that. That is very interesting. Vaughn doesn't have any support either, which is another really bad thing. I don't know what is this man doing. Let's go for I don't know if this is going to break it or not. Oh, it will. Okay. I think the fact that he put up the Bond buff card actually kind of screwed him there. All right, he dies at the beginning of the next turn, I think. Well, no, he I think he has Tarmiel Grace on him. Because that was a lot of HP regained. Which then again, I did a lot of damage to him, so I'm pretty impressed with that. Okay, I don't have a rupture card this time, so I'm not going to be able to beat through this as easily. Puts up another buff, okay. He is hitting me, so I'm gaining melee stacks as well. I think we go for something like this. Ooh, that beat through very nicely. This kills, boom, nice. And then this will be kind of a waste of a ultimate removal card, but oh well. All right, so I guess this just goes to show synergy is a lot better than just throwing a whole bunch of festival units on a team. So yeah, all right. He doesn't have any way to remove this ultimate either. So I think I'm in the clear. I think we'll try to use the rupture card first. He doesn't actually have buffs on, so maybe not. I'll try it out either way, because I have decent stacks. Nah, let's go ahead and just use the ult. It's whatever. And then I'm confident enough that we're going to kill that I'll just use the cleave card instead of the ultimate removal. Here we go. Boom. Didn't do as much as I was expecting. Should have used the amplify card here, but it should be okay. Ba-boom. Bam. Nice. All right. Move to the next one. Alrighty, what do we got? Okay, so we have the Lilia team. I really don't go against a whole lot of Lilia teams, but obviously she is quite tough to deal with. So if we can, let's try to, I think I'm going to waste that, try to get some damage off, and then disable her, so that way we don't have to worry as much about her dissolve card, because that would be really nice. It's either dissolve or ultimate removal. I can't remember which Lilia has which card, because I don't have this Lilia, so I don't get to use her, which is very sad. But either way, pulled another rupture card. The one time I get rid of a card that I could have merged, I do not pull, or I pull the other one. That still did a ton of damage. Holy. All right. Okay, spacing your damage out a little bit here, which is kind of odd to me. I think we'll just go ahead and throw this out again. We've got three stacks. I think I'm just going to try to get rid of Lilia here. I don't think I'm going to. Boom. Ooh, good damage though. 167 is not bad with only three stacks. Okay. We've got our taunt up. I don't know how this is going to go, but we'll see. Okay, boom. Decent counter. 79k is not bad at all. This is going to hurt. Ooh. Nice. 129. She's dead now. 38k regen. He survives. We're gods. All right. Nice, nice. That was exactly what you want. All right. So, honestly, I think we'll just get rid of Escanor in this situation. Because although Kyo is like a kind of a threat, I feel like Escanor can deal more damage. We'll disable him so that way he doesn't get the, he has Blaze and Co-Destruction, I think, on his card, so he won't be able to take advantage of the extra ignite damage or whatever. Which is, I mean, the ignite damage will still be there, but he won't get the effect damage plus the ignite damage. So, I don't know. Not enough. Counter, 74. Not bad. He's fed Melee a couple of more stacks here, so I think we'll try to do something like this. And we should be good to go. Obviously, these aren't like crazy matches or anything like that. Plus, I've noticed that when I play during the day, like it's 2 p.m. in the afternoon. So you would expect there to be players on. I feel like I always find players at nighttime for me, or just like at reset is when a lot of people play. So I don't know what to think about that. We'll buy one more ticket for the 5-match sweep, and we'll be right back. Alrighty, for our last match, we have a Bond team, which I'm glad I have Cusack for. I honestly think the only thing that the melee team, like the assault mode melee team, needs is someone to cancel stances. If you could cancel stances with the melee team, honestly, you'd be really well off. Like, it would be so good. I wonder if we disable him. I don't actually want to get rid of that. Let's disable him. Hit this, we'll waste that. Because I'm wondering if I disable him with skill effects, if he puts up the taunt, will I still lose ultimate move gauge? I would imagine not, but I also wouldn't put it past the game to not work that way. So we shall see. I, of course, pull the extra rupture card after I use it. I need to stop doing that, I guess. The Bond team is very scary because it can shoot melee down pretty quickly, because honestly the only thing... Oh, it actually purged the debuff as well, so I guess that is a good indicator that it is not going to work. This isn't going to work either. I can't ult rush because Terry's going to take off my ultimate move gauge. So I'll have to wait a turn and then put up a stance so that way he can't target. But even then, it might be too late because he's going to get ults on characters. Oh boy. If he doesn't put up another Arthur stance, I'll be in a halfway decent position. Okay, he removes the ultimate gauge for no reason. Like, actually, he removed two, so it's not an awful reason. He didn't put up a stance either, so we're going to stance, we're going to remove his ultimate move gauge, and hit him with a decent amount of damage. I'll get my ultimate. Nice, good damage there. We kill. 202k is not bad at all. Like, actually super impressive. My biggest concern is getting enough damage out to kill Arthur. He doesn't have Holy Relic on Twiggo, which is actually... really surprising. I feel like Twiggo's the easiest one to get the relic for, and he's actually super helpful. So, kind of weird. Holy, that was a lot of damage on my man. He's dead. He's gone. Goodbye. Oh, man, that was actually kind of disappointing. We get two stacks on melee. I have buffs too, because that's the way melee works. He's only 5-6, but he's also a red unit. Oh, not good. I don't really... I think I'm dead either way. Melee has a decent amount of lifesteal, so depending on how much damage this does, 77k, not great. Eh, you got 55k back. That's honestly not bad at all, but I highly doubt we can tank a hit here. Not gonna be good, not gonna be good at all. That was pretty much to be expected. Oh well. Well, I mean, honestly, that's, you know, the Bond team has always kind of been a threat to melee, and I have to say, I'm just impressed that, you know, putting the Tarmiel Relic on it, we really didn't even get a whole lot of, like, use out of the Tarmiel Relic there, because they didn't, like, focus on, you know, melee at all, which is kind of weird, but yeah, either way, still pretty good. I really like it, actually. Whenever we used it last time, we got a whole lot of like use out of it. Maybe not a whole lot of use, but in the same video that I was talking about doing last week, we actually faced an assault mode melee, and just out of curiosity, I wanted to see how well it was going to do, so I attacked into melee and stuff, and it was very impressive how much like HP he gains back, and it keeps him alive for longer, and obviously as you attack him, you feed him stacks and everything. It's just, I don't know, it's a really cool concept to me, and I really like assault mode. Hopefully he'll get some more like demon support sometime in the nearish future, but that's it for me. So, I don't know. Bit of a weird episode. Bit of weird, or it's more of a video, not really an episode. But either way, thank you guys so much for watching. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed the video. Feel free to subscribe if you have not already. Hopefully, I'll be back in my normal setup. It'll be about a week or so. So, all of this week's videos are probably going to look like this, but it's fine. See you next time.